What's going on, YouTube? This is Necrostevo, and today we have an Omega Ruby Alpha Sapphire EV training tutorial. Be sure to leave a like if you find this useful, and feel free to share it with other people in your rivals and your communities. If you are familiar with the basics of EV training, feel free to click the annotation, of course, to skip to the hotspots at the end of the video. This isn't very long, but I did want to make sure I go over what EV training is and why one would bother after value training at all. So, without further ado, let's get into a little bit of the math and what you need to start EV training. Now, effort value training is very simple to do now. It used to be a lot more difficult, but thankfully they put a lot of new tools in the game to make it a much more easy task. That being said, why would you want to bother with it in the first place? It's because you're going to be putting extra stat points onto each one of your Pokemon stats that you're going to effort value train for. Also, generally, if you play competitively, your opponents will be effort value training, so if you do not, you could possibly be at a disadvantage of up to 63 stat points for anything besides HP. Now, before you even start, if this is your first time EV training, make sure you understand the math and the stats that you want to change, and I'm going to break down a little of that briefly. But also, I'm going to let you know the held items that you need to have, how to get the Pokerus, Sweet Scent, and the spread move that you might consider using in the hotspots or the places that you're going to be going to actually KO the Pokemon you need for EV training. Now, for example, most Pokemon are going to give a single EV point towards a stat. There are some Pokemon that give 2 EVs and even some that give 3 EVs in certain circumstances. Even some Pokemon, of course, can give different EVs for multiple stats at the same time. Now, when you're battling, EV points are only rewarded when a Pokemon receives experience points. This not only counts if they can level up and they actually get the experience points, or if they're at level 100, it can level up no further. If they would have received the experience points, then they are going to get them at the end of the battle. If a Pokemon is in a battle and it runs from the battle, or if a Pokemon is KO'd and would not have received any EV points because it was KO'd during the turn of the battle, it ends like that, that Pokemon is not going to get any effort value points. Of course, you can always view the points that you're gaining through the super training bottom screen, the little bar on the right side of the screen. Well, you know how many EV points that you have, or if you're getting close to maxing out. There are several different ways to manipulate EV points. You can do it through held items, such as the power items or the Macho Brace, the Pokerus, super training, and of course, if you need to decrease your EVs, you can use the super training reset bag or certain berries that decrease different EVs as well. Now, generally, like I said, each Pokemon that you defeat is going to give a certain amount of EVs. For example, Geodude will only give you 1 defensive EV point. In any stat, the maximum amount of EVs you can do is 252. For every 4 points that you get effort points for, you're going to get a single stat point. So if you defeat 4 Geodude, it's like getting +1 in defense. But that would mean to get the maximum amount of effort value points, you would need to defeat 252 Geodude, and that just doesn't make sense. Why take all the time to do that? Fortunately, there are horde battles and super training on the bottom screen to help you out with this. In a horde battle, if there are 5 Geodude, you're going to be getting 5 defensive points per battle, assuming you KO all the Geodude appropriately, and you get to the end of the battle with the Pokemon that you want trained. Now, while that does make things 5 times faster, that's still not really efficient to get into that many battles with 5 points per battle. That's where the Pokerus comes in, which of course is a virus that Pokemon can get that enhances the way that they grow. The Pokerus can occur randomly throughout gameplay, or what I recommend is get involved in a community, or just go on Twitter, or Smogon, or something like that. Someone will be happy to trade you a Pokemon that has Pokerus. It's very easy to transfer to another Pokemon, and if you just keep a Pokemon with Pokerus in your box, then you will always have it. Of course, if the Pokerus sign, the little purple sign, turns into a happy face, that means that Pokemon still has Pokerus, so they'll still get double EVs, but they aren't able to transfer Pokerus to other Pokemon. Now, say you double the amount of battle EV points that you get with a horde battle and just the Pokerus. That's getting 10 EV points per battle. That's great. But what if you can do even more than that? And that's where held items come in. The power items, such as the power weight or the power bracer, they each correlate with a specific stat and will give you +4 EVs to that specific stat. So if you stack Pokerus and the power items, that means each Geodude in the battle will be giving you 1 EV +4, which equals 5, multiplied by 2, which equals 10. So each Geodude in a battle will be giving you 10 EV points, or since there's 5 Geodude in one Horde battle, you're getting 50 EV points. Now that is a great deal. So what do those 50 EV points really mean? What's the quickest way to EV train a Pokemon? The absolute fastest way to EV train a Pokemon is go and purchase some vitamins such as carbos, iron, calcium. You can get all these from the Lilico department store on the third floor. Or of course, if it's one of the special sale days, you can get them from one of the special sell places for a discounted price. I do recommend using bargain power when you're shopping for those because they can get kind of expensive. And I also have a tutorial up for making money if you need it. But the point is, you can use 10 vitamins, each vitamin gives you 10 each EVs towards a stat, to get the first 100 EVs. After that first 100, you cannot use any more vitamins. So it's more efficient to use vitamins before you start EV training against wild Pokemon or using super training. After you have that first 100 EVs, go and fight 3 hordes. You're essentially getting 50 EVs per horde, and that's gonna put you at 250 EVs, which means you just have 2 points left over. And that's quickest usually to get either by just defeating a single Pokemon or going into super training and punching on a bag or doing one of the quick training simulators. Now, if you need more specific numbers than just 252 in any one stat, for example, if you're preparing for a tournament or if you're trying to hit a certain speed number or you want a divisible HP number that you won't take stealth rock damage and be KO'd on 2 switch ins, be sure to use a little bit of math there. A lot of the damage calculators and stat calculators can help you out with that. But if you're not sure that works, I recommend, again, asking your rivals and your communities. A lot of people play Pokemon, so a lot of people have figured this out. So having someone explain it to you rather than guessing or wasting a lot of time and being frustrated can sometimes be more efficient on your end as well. Now that we have the math out of the way, where do you really need to go to figure out EV training? What do you need to bring with you? I really recommend that you utilize Sweet Scent or Honey to force Horde battles. Of course, Honey is an item that you can get through Combee. Just having it in battle, it may sometimes find Honey. Or some Pokemon can learn Sweet Scent, and they will use that in the grass, and you can find Horde battles that way. Otherwise, walking around in circles waiting to encounter a Horde battle randomly might take a little while. I will also recommend bringing a spread move. A spread move, of course, is a move that can hit multiple Pokemon in battle, and that way, you do not have to attack each Pokemon individually in a Horde battle. You can just wipe them all in one hit. I have a few examples here. My particular favorite in Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire is Tropius. It's because he can fly. But here's a few examples of some Pokemon that get Sweet Scent and a spread move. Of course, the earliest one that you encounter in the game normally, I believe, is Oddish. You encounter him pretty early on, and he gets Sweet Scent very early on as well. Of course, Gloom doesn't get Petal Blizzard until something like level 50. But you can at least use the Horde battles to level up quickly or start your EV training relatively early on in the game. So now that you have all the tools that you need to EV train, the question is, where do you go to EV train? If you look at the Pokemon that I have displayed on the screen, all these locations and these Pokemon are 100% encounters for the specific EV stat that you are targeting. So if you need only HP, I recommend going to Rust's Durf Tunnel and encountering Whismur. He's the only Horde in that area, just like the other Pokemon that I have listed here. Now, a special note for Swablu and for Zigzagoon. Sometimes they appear alongside other Pokemon. In Swablu's case, that's not a big deal if you were playing Alpha Sapphire, because in Alpha Sapphire, it will appear alongside Lotad, which also gives a single special defense point. In Omega Ruby, Swablu may appear aside a C-Dot on Route 114, so in that case, don't go to Route 114 for Omega Ruby, go to Route 115. The grass there takes a little longer to walk to, but you will only encounter Swablu hordes. For Zigzagoon, there is a chance that he could appear alongside Wingull and or Swellow, or sometimes there's Wingull and Swellow hordes. Either way, all three of those Pokemon, Zigzagoon, Wingull, and Swellow, all give a single speed point. So now I hope you all have found this tutorial helpful. Please leave a like if you did enjoy it, as these the like system here on YouTube really does help videos maintain their visibility. And let me know if you have any particular EV training tips or tricks that you use in Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire that I may not have mentioned, because the more people talk about things, of course, the better knowledge everyone can have. So I hope you guys have a great day, and I'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.